Now, I got bad news and good news. The bad news is that it's a subject that's kind of hard to follow intuitively, and the good news is that nobody can follow it intuitively.
It is said that nothing in the universe travels faster than light, but even light takes its time to journey across the universe. Yet, imagine this. Two quantum particles separated by unimaginable distances, light years apart, somehow remain connected. But when we observe one of them, the other one, that is galaxies away, changes its spin instantly. This mind-bending connection is called quantum entanglement. And how does it happen? Nobody on Earth truly knows. And just like that, consider this superposition. It states that an electron can be in multiple places at once. These aren't just abstract ideas in textbooks. These are the fundamental rules governing our reality. Yet, they are still largely unknown to humankind. Light. It is the fundamental entity of the universe. It moves, it oscillates, it bends. But what is it? Is light a particle or a wave? Or is it something beyond our intuitions?
Light passes through the two slits, goes over to the other side. Instead of a screen over here, we've actually got a camera, because this detects really low levels of light. You can see what the camera's picking up. The first surprise is it's picking up dots, blips. This is light traveling through this. But have a look at this. If we collect up all these blips collected over a time period and have a look at what the pattern is, we see something quite remarkable. The pattern you see is the pattern that waves make. But the light arrives in blips, in packets, in as small particles, which physicists call photons.
But the fundamental question that lies is that how can light be both a particle and a wave? It defies logic, but still, it works. When Heisenberg and others first unveiled the principles of quantum physics, it felt like the foundation of all of physics were shaking. Because the rules that govern our big familiar world, they just simply don't apply in the quantum world. To understand these complexities, physicists had to invent a whole new kind of mathematics. A mathematics built not on certainties, but on probabilities. Why? Because down at the quantum level, particles aren't in definite states. Not really until we actually measure them.
Some physicists have always objected to that probability interpretation, Einstein in particular, and Schrödinger himself did not like it. But still, after a lot of study and passage of several decades of time, this remains as the only general interpretation of quantum mechanics. One has to accept it because one cannot improve on it.
Today, our understanding of quantum mechanics has exploded. We are no longer just observing, we are starting to engineer it. Things like quantum computers that can compute septillion times faster than our traditional supercomputers. And a new perspective in looking towards the life through the lens of quantum biology. Humankind has achieved great things and continues to do so. Understanding how the quantum world works can lead us to huge advancements and contribute greatly to our evolution in the universe. The beauty of quantum mechanics lies in the uncertainties that give rise to this beautiful world.